Hello there, and many thanks for tuning in to Sports Friday. It's the first date of the month of March. Many thanks for being part of Y254 Sports Friday. It's all about sports. And AD, how are you?
Yes, Hillary. I'll be co-hosting with Hillary today.
Right.
No, come on, mechanganikiwa kidogo. Cut bit your tongue. Manchester, it's really getting to you guys right now. So the reality is starting to shape up, I think.
No, we're doing well. It doesn't matter whether Arsenal you are coming up or you are not. Otherwise, back home, we have so much lined up for you, including what has just happened this very day. We will be looking at the post-analysis of the English Premier League and a mention of the Kenya Premier League fixtures this very day. My name is Edereva Hillary. A very warm welcome to the program. So, Eddie,
yeah.
This very day, the vacation promotion... The vacation of the appointment of the CSHSA has been vacated.
Yes.
And now CS Amina is the CS for education. Ambassador Dr. Amina Mohammed is the CS for sports
and
now.
Culture.
She has been reassigned there.
Yeah.
What's your take?
Well, I'm not quite sure how I'm supposed to respond to this. How much Amina knows about I know she knows much about being a CS. I just don't know how much she knows about sports and culture.
Right.
But at this point, I think the sports ministry was too desperate that they would just want anyone different, just not the same person that was there. Like anyone, just not the one that is at the moment. So I think it should bring something different.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just hope she can live up to the task,
right?
Because there's so much to do.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much was that the former CS didn't like accomplish,
mm-hmm.
that he was expected to accomplish.
True.
In regards to stadiums, in regards to like keeping us updated. In fact, it's like everything was just a mess. Even like the sports fund was always a problem.
All right.
So let's just hope Amina can do something different.
Actually, speaking of the stadiums, I remember during the campaigns, the deputy president said a lot of in regards to the stadiums, and I am like, this was the man who was supposed to like to push president.
Yeah.
You said of the five stadiums, where are they? My
yeah.
people want this, but that hasn't happened for the last like three times.
And I think the worst part about it was it's not just that they were not built and he was not pushing. It's like we were not feeling like he's doing anything.
Right.
Because most of the time, like even when the question was still was so much surrounding the sports and issues regarding the stadiums,
mm-hmm.
you would never hear him speak about anything. So it would like you'd like beg to wonder like, is it really like following up?
I don't know. Maybe there are things he has done, but we haven't seen them. And if they have been there, I don't know much to be spoken. But we also have problems with sporting activities. We had problems with our athletes. We've been having problems with Harambee Stars, the
true,
facilitation
true.
Fee.
True.
We had the problems with the coach. As in, I mean, do you think Amina is gonna change things now?
Well, for one thing, I can say we did see her do a lot in education,
mm-hmm.
and we really did see a push for a lot of changes in education, and most of those changes came through,
right.
and a lot of them are working and are being implemented in such a manner that you'd feel like there was so much change done in it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, if she can do the same thing in sports, well, right. I'm all for it. I'm not going to judge her before she starts her job,
mm-hmm.
so I'm gonna let her just do her thing, and then after that, I'm going to speak my piece.
Initially, she is known to perform what she does. She does it very well, and now she's moving from education, and just the other day there were issues with her, but now she's in sports. I have seen a lot of memes trending about
but that's the point. like ever since last year, you've been like hearing Amina, like her name has been constant. Like she's been that just shows you how much she's pushing for changes in the education sector. So it was something that we lacked when it came to the former CS. So right now we are hoping like she would do the same. Like me, I don't mind hearing her name on news every day, as long as me hearing her name on news every day just shows me how much she's pushing.
All for good reasons.
All
actually.
For good reasons, of course. But sometimes, you know, good comes out of bad and bad comes out of good. So you never really know where you have to shake some things so that you can... You can know what to do.
So she's
better.
Coming in to meet the NOC, the FKF, everything from sports to the athletes. As
true.
In, I mean, she will be having too much to handle at such a time, because if it is true what is said, that like CSHS did nothing as far as sports culture and heritage is of concern, I kind of believe she's coming to do a lot of work. And do you think she will streamline this area? Remembering there has been allegations of misconduct of public funds.
True.
Kama ile yenye waliendanga Rio, your story sijui iliendangaje.
You know,
speaking of doping.
Yeah, and then kuna hizi like even those ones are a bit serious. There was this petty things like usijua wachezaji wajalipwa mshahara, sijui kocha wajalipwa mshahara. Those are things like okay, we are Kenya, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a level of improvement and development that we have so much overcome. And kuna shida zingine like shida zenye tulikuwa tunasikia enzi za Fabish are not the same cases we are supposed to be hearing today, you know.
True.
Yeah, so if she can deal with those petty things and then now come to the big things, I would like it even much better, especially considering Harambee Stars is going to the AFCON.
Okay, maybe in few words, her first day, 100 days in office, what do you think she should change?
Wow, I can't even know where to start, but I think first, what she really needs to do, as to my opinion, is just assure Kenyans that she is here and she knows what she's doing,
mm-hmm.
and whatever it is that was a problem before,
right,
she knows how to take care of it and she will take care of it,
mm-hmm.
you know, because sometimes I think it's the faith that we lack in the government in regards to sports that was the problem.
True.
So she just needs to restore that faith,
mm-hmm.
so that however much time she may need, we will give it to her,
right,
in regards to the faith that she will be asking from us.
All right, as for me, I'll be expecting her to address the financial issues we've been having. Our coaches have not been paid, the players are not being paid.
Yeah, even the rugby well. Squad.
We had problems with our athletes. Wakirudi hawakui welcome. We want them when they come with those goals that we celebrated them on TV. Let us celebrate them even at airport and even ensure that things flow and the stadiums that were promised, if they are there, we need to see players using those stadiums. And
it's really embarrassing.
Nationals in any matches here in our country, we don't have to go. Let them come and see the beauty of Kenya.
Imagine mpaka leo NJ funguliwa.
Hata
Nyayo stadium.
Nyayo venye walijenga, it's something else, and I don't want to talk about it.
Some things are just too embarrassing, especially considering that this is Kenya and this is Nairobi, so things that are in the city are not being done. Mm. Anyway, let's just wish her the best.
All right, I want us to talk about the KPL fixture, about what will be happening with our boys back home. If we could be having that fixture on our screens now, our director, if you can hear us, we have the fixtures.
Yeah, there's so much in the Kenyan Premier League. Recently,
the FC Leopards will be playing Suni Sugar.
Yeah. And even just in the midweek, Gor Mahia played the fixture with Tusker,
mm-hmm.
and Gor Mahia won.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm think well, the way the league is going, it's like Gor Mahia is trying to like reestablish themselves, and with the kind of adjustment they have put in and the kind of improvement they have made, mm-hmm. since they started the league, I think they're well on track to go back to the top.
I remember, I think, is it last week I told you Gor Mahia will come, because Gor Mahia is Gor Mahia.
I know. I am Kogalo, but still, you do have to see the changes that have been happening in sports of late. Mm-hmm. Like the way the Kenyan Premier League has improved and the way some teams are playing, you kind of feel like they should be put through.
Mm-hmm.
Like your hustle inafaa kuwa ngumu kidogo, it should be that easy for them, unajua?
Right.
Like the way Kakamega and Kariobangi Sharks are playing, mm-hmm. the way Bandari are playing, you know, it should be the improvement, it shouldn't be that easy for Gor.
Just to mention, do you think Amina should have more stress on this this league, because this is the team that will come to form the Harambee Stars?
To be honest, I think when it comes to sport, there's just too many problems that the league seems like it's way better. Like kwa sasa,
mm-hmm.
league it doesn't really need much addressing. Mm-hmm. She should just see to mambo ya nini, other things like mambo ya Harambee Stars is just pathetic,
mm-hmm.
and stadium issues. So me, I really don't see any reason for her to really focus on the league.
All right, our viewers back home, I hope you're seeing what will be happening.
Yeah, there are a lot of matches. Like this KCB, KCB versus Sofapaka versus KCB. This one will be promising.
Mm-hmm.
Sofapaka has really been okay. By the way, this is something I'm saying on a very, very serious level. The football Sofapaka is playing is out of, like, it's really good.
Mm-hmm.
The day they played Gor Mahia, I really saw Gor struggle, and it was really interesting.
Right.
So I would really like Sofapaka to like just improve on the little bit that they were lacking, like the finishing end.
Right.
But as far as like taking control of the game, they know how to do it. The FC Leopard and Sony Sugar, that one is another Western derby.
Mm-hmm. Mathare United and Bandari.
Mathare United and Bandari, that one is really, really promising. In fact, I think this is like the biggest game. Mm-hmm. The Mathare United and Bandari, I think it's the biggest game of the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think there's any game bigger than it in the weekend because like...
Who will carry the day?
I'm not sure because Mathare are really stubborn, but Bandari are really on form.
They are coming too.
Yeah, they are really, really, really on form. So it's really hard to tell who is who and what is what.
All right, I want us now to move to the English Premier League post-analysis where things happened.
Yeah.
I'm sure Arsenal fan sitting next to me is very proud. I don't know. This tunnel with tunnel plus Liverpool.
No, it wasn't just matters Arsenal. The Premier League was really entertaining this weekend. Actually, most people really expected Manchester United to lose, seeing that they had like about 10 players from the first 11
right.
missing. Mm-hmm. But in a lot can be said about Manchester and a lot can be said about Ole Gunnar, but I
right.
really, really think that the coach is really doing a good job. Mm-hmm. As you can see, this was the Arsenal match.
Right.
And that was a really stellar performance from Arsenal.
Mm-hmm.
I really, really, this is like the kind of football that you expect to see Arsenal play.
Mm-hmm.
For the first time, Ozil performed. Okay,
right.
for a first time in a very long time because he's been really seeing some bench time. Ozil performed to the expectations.
The rumored lazy man.
Yeah.
And Mkhitaryan carried the day.
Yeah, Mkhitaryan was like the man of the match. He assisted like 3 goals and scored 1. That was not a joke.
Actually, he made history, I think, in consecutive CG Premier
matches. Yeah, he had scored, previously he had scored 1 goal and assisted 1.
Right.
And then he came to the next game and assisted 3 and scored 1.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it was just the combination between him and Ozil. Like, you can see he assisted Ozil's goal,
right.
and then Ozil came back and assisted his goal.
Yeah.
So I think Arsenal really, if they can like emulate exactly what they did on this to
right.
the Tottenham game this weekend, I think they can really do much good. But you also have to consider that in this match,
mm-hmm.
Bournemouth lacked like about 8 players from the first 11.
All right.
So Arsenal really found a really, really weak Bournemouth.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just not to put a lot of pressure on them because, yeah, it was different. But me, at the moment, the only problem I'm really having with Arsenal
mm-hmm.
is Aubameyang.
All right.
Yes, the guy is scoring. But in like 90% of the game, or should I say, okay, let me just say like 80% of the game, it feels like, I always feel like he's lost.
And actually, he's in the race for the Golden Boot.
He's in the race for the Golden Boot.
He's
16
so
goals
so
where
far.
He is right now at 19, I think.
But now, Arsenal.
Yeah.
There's something about you guys because you'll be playing Tot and Chelsea didn't manage to beat Tottenham. So now this coming weekend you'll be with them. I don't know what will happen.
It will be a very, very interesting fixture considering Arsenal are really not at their best, but also Tottenham are really not at their best. Even though Harry Kane is back,
mm-hmm.
Harry Kane is still struggling to find form.
Right.
So I'm not quite sure because Tottenham right now have like lost 2 games consecutive. They lost like the Burnley game
mm-hmm.
and now they have lost there.
But let's talk about Manchester United against Crystal Palace.
Manchester United against Crystal Palace. Now, that was the match that most people expected Crystal Palace to win,
mm-hmm.
considering the fact that they had drawn
actually,
with Manchester.
Actually, Nigeria Wali bet.
Wali drawn at Manchester. They drew with Manchester
mm-hmm.
at Old Trafford.
And Lukaku
and then,
came back.
And then all of a sudden, Manchester is lacking players,
mm-hmm.
and Crystal Palace are at the form of their lifetime. And they're losing this match, and I'm like, what's wrong with Crystal Palace? But Crystal Palace was applying the right pressure. I think Manchester United have just like mastered that thing. Like, you will have few chances, just use them at your best
mm-hmm.
to make the best most, like, make the most out of the little that you get. And that is pretty much what Manchester United is doing. Every time they get a chance, they make the most of it.
Right.
And that is how they just assassinated this game.
What you do say about Lukaku because he was so lost in the bush?
Well, Lukaku proved his fans wrong. Lukaku for a very long time performed like the striker that we expect him to be.
All right.
He performed like the striker that was leading the team.
All right.
And I think to some extent I would say that Lukaku really, really impressed me.
All right.
Yeah. He did beyond my expectation.
We expect more this weekend. How about Liverpool and Watford?
Now, Liverpool and Watford, that was ridiculous.
I think it was a weak team.
That was ridiculous. I'm not quite sure even what happened there because before Watford were from like
mm-hmm.
a 5-0 win
mm-hmm.
from their previous game.
Mm-hmm.
And then they come to this match and then like lose 5, like it's a joke. That was really disappointing.
Right.
But you also have to give credit to Liverpool. They really played their best.
Mm-hmm.
Mane was doing things. In fact, the Mane goal was really impressive. I really never expected that. I didn't see that coming. But I have to say, Liverpool did play their best. So to take not to take credit away from them, it was a Jurgen Klopp masterclass.
All right, we will be taking a very short break, and when we come back, we will look at two other teams. That is Chelsea and Man City. We want to see what these people did and what went wrong for them and what went good for them. Keep it Y254 Sports. Freddie takes a short break. Don't go too far.